So what do we do with Megaphone Guy?
He's not the smartest person at the party, or the most experienced, or the most articulate, but he's got that megaphone.
Megaphone Guy.
Some are agreeing with him, some disagreeing. But because he's so loud, their conversations will begin to react to what he's saying. As he changes topics, so do they. If he continually uses the phrase, at the end of the day, they start using it too.
It's our users who control what they see.
Old technologies get confused with new ones.
Making money.
His main characteristic is his dominance. He crowds the other voices out.
But who can publish information to the web?
His rhetoric becomes the central rhetoric because of its unavoidability.
Host original content.
Unavoidability.
Unfortunately,
milliseconds.
When you use a search engine,
unavoidability.
You will also find what is called user-generated content.
We consider speech to be the result of thought, but thought also results from speech. As we grope in words towards meaning, we discover what we think.
The number one thing we do is give people a voice.
This yammering guy has, by forcibly putting his restricted language into the heads of the guests, put an intelligence ceiling on the party.
Right. Thank you so much for articulating our business model.
So what do we do, Megaphone Guy? I mean, he's here.
And it pops you into the content itself.
Well, one thing I think you try to do is not be him, which we all are.